そしてもし日本という国の法律をきちっと守ろうとするのであれば、1平方メートルあたり4万ベクレルを超えるような汚染地帯は放射線管理区域にしなければいけないのですが、その面積は2万平方キロメートルにも及んでいて、東北地方、関東地方の広大な地域を無人にしなければいけないというほどの汚染を受けてしまっています。その現実を見て、日本の政府は到底その汚染地帯にいる人々を助けることはできないと判断しまして、汚染地帯に人々を見捨てるということにしてしまいました。今現在もほとんど多分1000万人にも及ぶ人たちが、本当であれば放射線の管理区域にしなければいけない地域に取り残されて、日々被爆をしているという事態が進行しています。
A third-party committee headed by a former judge has cleared the operators of the Fukushima Daiichi plant of accusations they lied about conditions at the facility. The case goes back to February of last year. A team of government investigators was due to inspect the plant's number one reactor, but they abandoned their plan after what one former investigator said was information from Tokyo Electric that the building inside was pitch dark and dangerous. This turned out to be false.Responding to charges, the company deliberately misled inspectors. TEPCO appointed a team of third-party investigators. The committee has handed its report to the utility president. It finds there was no systematic attempt to falsify information and the matter was a misunderstanding. But committee members add that Tokyo Electric officials should have consulted their supervisors before issuing the warning because it effectively blocked the inspection.TEPCO President Naomi Hirose says the utility will improve work procedures. He says he wants nuclear regulators to inspect the number one reactor.
The head of the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission has offered to help with the cleanup at Fukushima Daiichi. 4 out of 6 reactors were damaged during the earthquake and tsunami 2 years ago. 3 of them melted down. NRC Chair Allison McFarlane says the people who run Tokyo Electric Power Company will have to clear a lot of hurdles before they can clean up the plant. She visited the site in December. She expressed her respect for the 2,000 workers who are removing debris and spent fuel.
That was all very impressive. At the same time, there's clearly a huge amount of work that needs to be done there. They've got 4 reactors that are damaged.
McFarlane has offered to work with her counterparts at Japan's Nuclear Regulation Authority. She said she'd like to meet twice a year to share information and ideas.
Things have changed, though, at the Fukushima Daiichi over the past 2 years. Workers have brought it under control and are mapping out a plan for the decades-long decommissioning process. What happened at the nuclear plant is expected to linger for generations, and many residents worry that the radiation released during the meltdowns and the explosions may affect their health and their children's health down the road. NHK World's Jun Yotsumoto has that report.
Members of the Ikeda family enjoy their weekends together. They've moved to Nasushiobara City, 100 kilometers from their hometown in Fukushima. Koji Ikeda spends weekdays away from his family, working at a temporary job. His wife Michiko takes care of their sons, Yukiya and Yoshiki. I'm happy when the family is together.
The Ikedas came to this town in northeastern Japan to build a new life, but they haven't been able to leave their old life behind them. They face financial pressures. Worse, they are worried about the health of the youngest member of their family.
The couple built a home in Futaba, 3 kilometers from Fukushima Daiichi. They used to have picnics overlooking the plant. Now, no one is allowed to live there.Because of high radiation. The Ikedas still pay a loan on a house they will never live in again. But that's not their only burden. March 11th, 2011, Michiko Ikeda was at the nursing home where she worked. She was helping elderly people evacuate when she heard an explosion. She was showered with dust, but she had no idea she was being exposed to radiation. 4 months later, she found she had radioactive cesium in her urine. It was below government safety limits, but she felt uneasy. Soon after that, she received some long-awaited news. She was pregnant. I thought, why now? Is the baby all right? But being pregnant was such a blessing. I wanted to have the baby if I could. I struggled with my anxiety right up to the delivery. Yoshiki was born healthy and still is, but his parents wonder about the future.
I'm hoping he won't get sick. I hope he won't suffer any serious effects down the road.
Many of their former neighbors have similar concerns. The town officials moved the town hall to Saitama Prefecture, about 270 kilometers away. They have contacted their residents spread all over Japan to offer radiation tests, but they've only checked 700 people, 10% of the town's population. A shortage of staff and equipment has limited their progress. Town official Ryoichi Takemoto asked former residents to record everything, where they were at the time of the accident, and any health effects.
If anything happens in the future, we can hand out the records as evidence. Our position is, we're worried there may be health problems.
Michiko Ikeda is concerned too, and wonders if she's really safe. Who'll be responsible if she gets cancer? Who will help her children if they get sick? Who will pay for it all? Nothing has been resolved. Time just passes. I want to stay healthy, at least until my baby becomes an adult. Decaters and many others are not sure how their lives will unfold, but they do know they'll never have what they had, and they'll always worry about their health. Jun Yotsumoto, NHK World, Na Su Shiobara, Japan.
Over the past 2 years, 14% of the 2 million people living in Fukushima have been tested for internal radiation exposure. The prefecture's health officials say that so far they have not found any exposure that implies health risks. But of course, authorities and experts agree they need to conduct more tests and long-term monitoring. Tourism in Fukushima took a major hit after the disaster. Foreign visits are down 70% compared to before March 2011. But local officials say radiation levels in most areas are no higher than in big cities around the world. NHK World's Takafumi Terui shows us what's being done to try to turn things around.
Manami Abe has spent the past 2 years waiting for foreign tourists to come back. She's a Fukushima native and has worked at a hotel in the town of Inawashiro for nearly a decade. She watched the business drop off after the nuclear accident.
I like to see my hotel busy.
For 2 years, the word Fukushima has made almost everyone think of the damaged nuclear plant. People who work in the tourism industry have been trying to change public perception. The local government is taking the lead. The governor himself visited Seoul last May in order to tell tourism officials and businesses that radiation levels are safe. South Koreans used to make up over 40,000 visitors to Fukushima each year. That's half of all international tourists. But the number dropped to 2,000 after the disaster. The only airline offering regular flights between Seoul and Fukushima temporarily suspended its route. A ski resort in Inawashiro, nearly 100 kilometers away from the stricken nuclear plant, hosted a World Cup freestyle competition last month. It was the first such contest there in 3 years. Local officials hoped it would help promote the area's safety.
100 is believing. We hope the tourists will talk about what they experienced when they go back to their country. That will gradually and steadily dispel negative rumors about Fukushima.
Just before the competition, local officials offered bargain price tours by chartering flights. More than 100 South Koreans took one of the chartered flights last month. They paid about $400 for their trip, including a hotel. That's around half of what they normally pay.
I'm so excited.
Dun. I'm looking forward to good snow, which I can't experience in my country.
Abe greeted the tourists. Many said the price of the package was attractive, but some still felt uneasy about visiting Fukushima. Staff at Abe's resort is trying to address those worries. They measure radiation levels on the slopes every morning. Then they post the results on their website. They say the levels are as low as those in major cities around the world. Ski resort operators are also offering discounts on lift tickets and accommodation for tourists.
I enjoyed the scenic views and skiing in Japan.
If my friends ask me about Fukushima, I'll tell them they don't need to worry about radiation at all.
Abe decided to give her guests handmade paper cranes on their last day. She wants tourists to leave Fukushima with good memories and to tell others to visit.
I hope they'll feel Japanese hospitality at least a little and visit Fukushima again.
Locals believe their efforts will eventually draw foreign tourists back to Fukushima and revive the regional economy. Takafumi Terui, NHK World, Inawashiro, Fukushima.
そしてもし日本という国の法律をきちっと守ろうとするのであれば、1平方メートルあたり4万ベクレルを超えるような汚染地帯は放射線管理区域にしなければいけないのですが、その面積は2万平方キロメートルにも及んでいて、東北地方、関東地方の広大な地域を無人にしなければいけないというほどの汚染を受けてしまっています。その現実を見て日本の政府は到底その汚染地帯にいる人々を助けることはできないと判断しまして、汚染地帯に人々を見捨てるということにしてしまいました。今現在もほとんど多分1000万人にも及ぶ人たちが、本当であれば放射線の管理区域にしなければいけない地域に取り残されて日々被曝をしているという事態が進行しています。